Do you guys do anything to unwind together after hard scenes you're both in? I'm going to answer this question
with wine. It's true. White wine. It is.
Yes. We have a wood ranch and a couple places in the Grove because we shoot right next to the Grove. Sometimes, man, like those hard scenes that we can do can be really, really exhausting. And so it's just nice. Also, it feels weird sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't, but it feels weird sometimes to have those sort of really emotionally like jarring and raw scenes and then just be like, okay, bye, see you tomorrow.
See you, girl.
Yeah.
Like, you just spilled your guts out. We've cried more than Niagara Falls. Like, and so sometimes it feels weird to just, like, part. And then, so yeah. It's nice to be like, that was really, it's nice to decompress and, like, talk about how the scenes went and how you felt and how, you know. And usually scenes like that, I mean, for me, they open up a lot. Like, yeah. I discover a lot during the scenes that even we don't do when we run them.
Oh, yeah. 100%.
And they, you know, they bring up emotions and they bring up, so it's nice to just go and be like, yeah, just talk about it.
Just drink and talk. And yeah. I mean, also I've found in a weird way that every time we have a storyline, like even the last one that we had, the cheating one, something is going on in our lives, like, mm-hmm. that we need to talk about. And it's just always kind of perfectly timed out that way.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we also go and, like, get lunch and dinner and talk about, like, other stuff, not even just after scenes. Like, I think that...
And I know people have asked, like, you know, how do you prepare for those kinds of scenes? Like, the preparation is in our day-to-day interaction.
Yeah.
You know, we have this unique job where, you know, we don't have a beginning and middle and end to our characters, really, at this point. We're in the middle. Mm-hmm. And so, because we shoot chronologically, mostly, like, we live our characters' lives day to day, so we're in it. But I think it's also, we also live our lives. Mm-hmm. So, you know, each day that goes by, we connect more and more and more and more and more. Mm-hmm. And that just adds a depth to, I think, hopefully, our performances and our interaction as our characters. That you would think that you would see off screen with the two characters, but you know.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I think that with any, you know, relationship on the show, like, the better friends the people are, the more that you can see it, and I think
that's true in relationships.
Yeah, exactly. So it's like, when we get to do those kind of scenes that are heavy, like, we're acting, so of course we're dragging in other feelings from different places in our lives or emulating those, but like, the stronger friendship, the more intense those scenes get, because you do have that, like, care for each other.
Yeah. And the more knowledge that we have to, you know, what each other is going through and in our personal struggles, like, it just, yeah, it makes it.
Yeah, and like, you can, it's like a weird, might sound manipulative, I don't know, but like, especially in acting, like, when you find, what is happening?
There's a garbage truck outside my house.
Yeah, there's dogs barking, there's garbage.
Oh, God.
Jesus. What's happening? But once you kind of learn each other's triggers, too, in scenes, like, and you can pull at them with each other, like, with each other's consent, obviously, but, like, you can tell when certain storylines affect the person personally. And if we want to use that, we can use that with each other.
Yeah.
And, like, that's where the trust part comes in. So, like, when you ask about, like, scene prep, it's like, yeah, of course we memorize and stuff, but so much of the scene prep is just us knowing each other.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, completely. So it's like, yeah, so. That was, I think, the historical, was that the last question we answered? to keep going on such.
Yeah. No, but it's good. I like the tangents. The tangents.
Yeah. It's good. Talking makes me nervous sometimes, but.
No. Uh-huh. No, I meant I know for me. That wasn't like a combination of you.
I did see someone ask what our zodiac signs are.
I'm a Capricorn.
I'm a Leo.
Aren't I so a Capricorn?
I guess, yeah. I mean, it's so funny. I think, like, in quarantine, so many of my... we all have, but just everything I believed in is just completely, destructive, just nothing anymore. So I'm like, yeah, sure, I'm a Leo. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'm not anymore. Maybe there aren't going to be stars anymore.
There's actually more stars than ever.
Oh, I can't. I haven't been outside at night, honestly. I've just been watching Sopranos. Yeah, just watching
I looked at the pink moon the other night. It was really pretty.
Pretty. Yeah.
Okay, I have one.
Okay.
We all want to see Tess's parents.
Me too, girl.
So my question is, are there any actors that you, Kate, would like to see play Tessa's parents?
Okay, so I had a joke answer for this, but I'm going to sit with it, because who the hell knows if it would work out, but I would say Jennifer Coolidge and John Stamos.
I love that idea. So for those of you that don't know, which is probably most of you,
low power.
Kate does an epic spot on Jennifer Coolidge impression. And Jennifer Coolidge is like one of my faves because I grew up watching Best in Show and Waiting for Guffman. So, and it's only gotten better over the years.
Oh my God. Thank you. It makes me so nervous. I can't do it now or I'll fuck it up.
I think you gotta do it.
Oh my God. There's some shit going on outside. Can you hear it?
Yo, there's like actions going on.
What is happening? What is happening to the world?
What is happening?
I actually think that's kind of sweet. I love that.
Sorry, I just...
Wow.
Sorry, got distracted there for a second.
Woo!
Sorry. That was actually perfect timing.
That's amazing.
Holy shit. Sorry.
My neighborhood is fun.
Clearly.
But. Wow, sorry. That just totally overwhelmed me emotionally. We both do good Jennifer Coolidge impressions, I feel like.
Nah, yours is better.
Mine's better when I'm, like, a little drunk. That was awesome.
Jesus.
But yeah, I would say Jennifer Coolidge and John Stamos for sure.
Okay.
Fuck
you.
Yeah.
Are up next.
I'm up next. Okay.
You're up next.
Next. Now I'm just going to do that accent for the rest of it. Oh. Him. If you could bring a superhero into YNR, who would it be?
Well, gonna have to go with my favorite superhero.
Okay. Well, yeah, who's your favorite superhero?
The problem is if I brought this character onto the show, I couldn't be her, and then I would just be jealous.
Okay.
So it's complicated.
Yeah, I get it.
But my go-to is Jean Grey.
Okay.
Jean Grey.
Okay.
What about you?
Batman. Just this. Christian Bale. Batman.
Oh, Christian Bale specifically, his Batman.
Yeah, just Christian Bale.
I think how on Val Kilmer's Batman?
Michael Keaton.
No, I couldn't imagine Michael Keaton's Batman. I want Michael Keaton's Batman.
That's what I want, too.
I want his for sure. Michael Keaton on our show? Are you kidding me? I would
die. I just
die.
Want any Batman. Maybe he could play my dad as Batman. Maybe Batman's my dad.
Man,
I'd be cool with that. Even Lego.
And
Batman.
I thought I was good having Saren and Nick as my parents, but if you had Batman as your dad,
you guys are the hottest parents. Holy shit!
I guess. Well, I don't.
Well, Isn't Nick your dad?
No, he's not my biological dad.
Okay.
But like, he acts as a father figure to Mariah. You not Joshua Morrow.
Oh, what? Yeah, no, not actually him.
I'm just saying the way that he jokes on set.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. No, he doesn't act like your dad.
He acts like a nuisance.
He acts like a bully.
He's a bully.
He's a bully.
So Josh texted me the other day, just out of the blue. And he was like, I have this plan. I think when we come back, you know, the fans are really going to want to see something spicy. So, like, I pitched to the network that Mariah dies. And I was like,
Oh my God.
Cool.
Oh my God. And, that's beautiful.
And I was like, oh, great, you know, awesome. And then he replied, he's like, the network loved it. So Mariah's getting thrown into a volcano.
No, a small volcano? Oh, my God. Why so aggressive? Dad.
You know, I've died basically every which way except getting mauled by a tiger.
Oh, well, you know who can't say that? Carol Baskin's husband.
Carol Baskin. Hey, all you cool cats and kittens, it's Carol Baskin here. Just wanted to come to you to say, don't die.
I just almost threw up. Dang. Wow. Now I'm just thinking about her house and her closet with all of her animal print, and I'm just like, damn, is that goals? Also, Jennifer Coolidge should play her in the movie.
And those wedding photos.
There's just all my tigers. I just love my tigers.
I just love. Oh God, she's funny.